Hello, race of gamers! In today's video, I will cover Aura Kingdom, an action anime MMORPG from the year 2013. If you want to know if it's worth playing in 2022, stick till the end of the video and I will present you my first impressions about this game. Let's start with the classes, because that is the first thing you do in any RPG. You pick your class. In Aura Kingdom, you have plenty of classes to choose from. You have the classic ones like Guardian, Duelist, Wizard, Sorcerer, Brawler, and some unique ones like Guitarist, Ronin, Shinobi, Starcaller, and even more. I picked for myself the Holy Sword class because I started to read Berserk manga and I wanted to feel like Guts, but maybe it wasn't the proper game to do so because of the overall cuteness found here. Okay, so after we chose a class, we were sent to the character creation screen. Here, things stayed pretty basic with just a few hairstyles option, some colors and some customs. Despite having a big selection of roles, the looks you can pick are pretty bland and a disappointment, but somewhat expected from classic anime MMORPGs. Okay, after I finished creating my avatar, the game gives me some option for a companion. They look kinda neat and had some skills too. I chose a fairy, because me, being a DPS class, I thought a healer would be good. After that being told, let's jump into the game and see what Aura Kingdom brings to the table. So, the game starts with an intro dungeon, nothing unusual. Here, I fight a monster, and I see that it has some telegraphed attacks, and that is always a plus for me, because I don't like to just stay in fixed locations and press buttons. Then, I use a badass combo on the final boss, and the game enters into something like a cutscene to show it to me. I can see from the start that the skills animations are pretty cool, eye-catching with a lot of effects. After I beat this guy, the game presents me a cutscene again, it tells me that I had a vision, and then I woke up in the starting zone. It gives me a cute black ram with tiny wings for a mount and I start taking quests from NPCs. The game doesn't look bad overall, it has nice graphics and a chill vibe, but there is too much UI for my taste, even after I made it smaller from the settings. One thing about the questing that I noticed from the start is that you can autopath. For me, this is the worst feature in anything else besides mobile games. I hate it so much because you will use it even if you don't like it because it's there. It destroys the immersion into the game and exploration element. You do the quests automatically and it will become a routine and eventually you won't feel any accomplishment when you finish a quest. At least this is my opinion. That being said, the questing overall is kinda basic. Go talk to an NPC, accept the mission, go kill X amount of this or gather X amount of that and come back, take your reward and jump to the next one. Later into the game, they started to implement some different quests with a more interactive part. Like this one, where I had to infiltrate a camp of pirates and plant some bombs without being detected by them. I had to sneak in order to complete this one. Other quests made me kill monsters for some kind of loot and then transform that loot into something else in order to finish it. But these were pretty boring too because I just clicked on the item in the quest bar and the automatic system did everything for me. So, this department was pretty much a routine and kinda boring. I felt engaged only in the sneaking missions. Okay, so let's talk a little about the gameplay and what mechanics does this game have. The combat felt pretty responsive, and how I told you before, it has some cool skill animations and effects. You have some combo skill that I used in the intro and after that with my companion. It is a powerful spell in a 1v1 situation, especially if you can get a critical hit. What I discovered, unfortunately, later in my gameplay is that I had a bar, and if it is full, I can do a more powerful version of the skill I use. The skill also has higher damage output, but it has different animation too, and some of them became AoE or have some other special effect. That was a cool mechanic, at least for my class. Let's talk a little about the overall atmosphere of the game. The overall graphics are pretty warm and they look good. If you turn off the UI, you can really stare at some beautiful zones, but sadly, Aura Kingdom is feeling empty. I had zero encounters with other players. I saw some activity in the world chat, but that was all. I don't know what was the max level, or if I reach any main city in my gameplay, and maybe all the players are at endgame, but this is the situation with most old MMORPGs nowadays, and the genre seems to be dying unfortunately. I hope the metaverse will change things, and the VR MMORPGs will be a success overall. Can't wait those days, but until then, we just have to play what is on the market. Okay, before we will talk about pros and cons, you can support the channel and my mental health with a like. It would let me know if you enjoyed the content. Also, you can be part of the legacy that I want to leave in this world by subscribing. It would motivate me to see someone appreciates what I do and I will be uploading more videos about games for you to know if you should try them or not. Also, feel free to comment if you think otherwise. I would like to know your opinion too and love any feedback. And don't forget, I try games, so you don't have to waste your time. Well, in conclusion, Ora Kingdom is a cool anime MMORPG with great skills effect animations, chill vibe and graphics, and a lot of classes to pick from. The auto-pathing for me in games is such a big turnoff. Maybe you will like it, depends from person to person, but that doesn't change the fact that the game has no player base and it feels empty and you have nobody to play with. So, in my opinion, the game is not worth your time. Irene doesn't approve. Okay, that will wrap it up for this video. See you next time and may the gods of good rap be with you in your grindy days.